Can somebody just shout hallelujah?
No, family.
I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to
away, you coffee, bra, bra, bra. Away. Coffee away.
I'm gonna be a good girl. Bye. Thank you. gentlemen, I do apologize. Certain people did not RSVP, so we had to work it out. So I need to resend the names to the priest to take you off. So if you go and your name is not there, do not be offended. I need to do that now. I do apologize. Sorry, no, we didn't resend it. Okay, then you might as well go that. Catch a moose, I bring him up. And then do that. Please.
Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen,
okay, it's not back now. Because I want to know.
Your name was not given to me. So I did not confirm that with the priest. So,
I'm going to go to the world. can't just do that. I'm sorry, my love. I'm sorry. We have to follow the protocol.
We need to. Because.
Alright, give me a. Oh, okay. Yes.
Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. In the waters of baptism, Ben died with Christ and rose with him to new life. He now share with him eternal glory. Challenges that we have to overcome because of the pandemic, the coronavirus. So this isn't normal service in many regards. So we've had to have lots of struggles with names and getting people to come in. But the most important thing we need to remember is that we're here to pray to God for love of men and for honesty. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. O God, who are mercy for sinners and the happiness of your saints, give, we pray, to your servant men whom you perform the fraternal office of burial, and share with your chosen ones the blessedness you give, so that on the day of resurrection, freed from the bonds of mortality, you may come with your face to our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated. Now, our first reading from the book of Isaiah, read by Colossians.
First reading from Prophet Isaiah 25, 6 to 9. On this mountain the Lord of hosts will prepare for all people a banquet of rich food. On this mountain he will remove the mourning veil covering all peoples, and the shroud enwrapping all nations. He will destroy death forever. The Lord will wipe away the tears from every cheek. He will take away his people's shame everywhere on earth. For the Lord has said so. That day it will be said, "See, this is our God in whom we hope for salvation. The Lord is the one in whom we hope. We exult and we rejoice that he has saved us." The word of the Lord.
Lord be with you.
God.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus exclaimed, "I bless you, Father, Lord of heaven and of earth, for hiding these things from the learned and the clever, and revealing them to your children. Yes, Father, for that is what I pleased you to do. Everything has been entrusted to me by my Father, no one knows the Son except the Father, just as no one knows the Father except the Son, and those to whom the Son chooses to reveal him. Come to me, all you who labor and are overburdened, and I will give you rest. Shoulder my yoke and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. Yes, my yoke is easy, and my burden light." Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated. So we are here today in order to say our farewell to men. Also, group of people who are joining us via YouTube this moment live, and all of you who come here to give your condolences to Ben's dear wife. If you read the tributes in the booklet, you'll see that she says that the circumstances of his last hours were very sad indeed. She was unable to be with him, and she heard the news. Suddenly, it's a shock that he passed away. He died. So it seems almost like a cruel joke. Just before we have this terrible pandemic where so much of our life is affected, people are worried and scared. Now we have this death and people are separated, husband and wife are separated. So we need to look to the Lord for the truth. Because the lie is that evil has the last word. Evil has overcome. Satan especially is ruling this world. But what we gather from what the Lord has revealed to us is that Satan has been defeated. This means that everything associated with the devil has been defeated. Even death itself. How? Because Jesus Christ took upon himself our human condition. He went to the cross, taking upon himself your sins and my sins. And there our sins have been nailed. He entered into the tomb, everyone who has died. But he is alive, he is risen. Jesus has risen to become Lord of heaven and of earth. There, when he descended into the realm of the dead, he bound Satan, put him in chains. And by rising from the dead, Jesus Christ transformed death. Death is no longer a curse, it is no longer the end. But in Jesus Christ, death is now a new beginning. This is the beginning of eternal life. Say that in baptism, when we're baptized, our eternal life begins then. Because in baptism, we enter into the tomb with Christ. And then, on the day of his baptism, was taken by the Lord, entered into the tomb, and was given the promise of eternal life. So now, Ben is on his journey towards the Father. So we can say, in some sense, lucky him, lucky Ben. He doesn't have to worry anymore about all of the problems of this world. He just needs to face the Father now. So we are gathered here in this moment to pray for him, to ask God to allow his Son, Jesus Christ, to wash them clean with the blood of Jesus, the blood that was shed on the cross, to scrub him up, to make him ready, to make him acceptable. And it is in this journey, in this passing from this world to the next, that we need to pray, particularly for them in this struggle. Some say that the moment of our death, we don't really know. Others say the moment our soul goes to God, we don't know. But for sure, we can be absolutely certain that Ben is present in his spirit. Ben will say, don't forget me, pray for me as I go to the Father. Ben was a regular here, as you know, at our church for 5 weeks. We always attend Mass every Sunday. We always have a word. When I would stand at the door greeting, greetings that would come through. Ben would always wave his finger and say, don't forget to visit my relatives. So now we commend God, commend Ben to God. Ask God to take them, to allow him to see the light of his face. And in this communion, this Holy Communion that we celebrate, we are remembering, we are doing what Jesus commands us to do, remember this until I come again. Jesus is our Lord, he is risen, and he promises all those who die in Christ the same resurrection. So let us now commend Ben to our loving Father. Father of mercies, the Father of God, the Father of all consolation. We pray for Ben now. We please stand. We are assembled here in faith and confidence to pray for Ben, Ohene Djan. Let's ask the Lord to strengthen our hope so that we may live in the expectation of Jesus' second coming. The response to our prayer is, hear our prayer. In baptism, Ben, Ohene Djan, received the light of Christ. Let us ask the Lord to scatter the darkness of our sadness and lead him over the waters of death. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Let us look to the Lord for comfort and consolation and ask him to heal our pain and dispel the darkness and doubt that comes from grief. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for all members of our family and friends, that we may be consoled in our grief by the Lord who wept at the death of his friend Lazarus. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Let us pray for all of us assembled here to worship in faith, we may be gathered together again in God's kingdom. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
In a moment of silence, we offer up a personal prayer to the Lord. Listen, Father, to the cry of your people. Remember Ben, Ohene Djan, and grant all those who died in Christ eternal rest. We ask this for the sake of Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated.
So that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ.
which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of the death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Vincent, our Bishop, his assistant bishops, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, the spouse of the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have believed you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you for your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, ever and ever. Amen. The Savior's command of walk by divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the power of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always." Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. We await the Saviour, the Lord Jesus Christ, who will change our mortal body.
place to receive communion spiritually. For those Catholics who are coming forward to receive communion, can you please come forward down the centre aisle and receive by taking your arms off first, at the point when you come forward. You then put out your hand and receive, and then you can consume the host in front of me. Then we ask you to go around the back, as you go around this way. This way we are observing social resistance rules, which are mandatory at this time.
Thank you.
Once again, thank you for showing support and esteem today. Thank you for your prayers and also your patience. As I said at the beginning, these are unusual times and we don't really want to celebrate in this way. We want to give glory to God and to praise Him with all our might and to thank Him. But we have to respect the circumstances of our situation. This is how it is. Nevertheless, it's important that we have joy in our hearts. Because Christ is alive, He's risen. So we commend Him now to God the Most High. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother. May our farewell express our affection for him. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again. The love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. Your hands, Father, with mercies, we commend our brother then in assurance as we hope, that together all who died in Christ will rise with him on the last day. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with the assurances of faith, until we all meet in Christ and with you and with our brother forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Thank you to the Reverend Pastor also for attending. Great consolation for the family, all of you who are here. Thank you to Mills for conducting this funeral. Also, thank you especially to Florence, who did a marvelous job with the booklet. A lot of work went into it. It's not easy organizing a funeral in this way, but she did a marvelous job, so thank you, Florence.
I'm going to go to the hospital.